Hi, welcome. Let's see quickly the main techniques to improve sound with FL Studio 12. If you find errors, please leave us comments below. When your project is done, its sound may be not good due to the high peaks that can cause distortion or saturation. In particular, this happens when the dB meter reaches the red level. Plus, not all the channel waveforms are equal. Some of them can have those high peaks, disturbing channels less intense. For these reasons, you need to limit or compress the channels, the pattern ones, or even the master one. Indeed, the master channel has already a plugin called the Fruity Limiter by default. This is one of the plugins used to improve sound in output. Two main techniques are used to improve sound: limiting and compressing. Both of them limit any sound that overcomes a volume threshold, especially to avoid distortion. The only difference is that the limiter can decrease the volume much more than what the compressor can do. These plugins are added through the mixer slots on the right, as you do with the sound effects. When your project is finished and you have a channel that risks saturation, select its mixer channel and add the Fruity Limiter plugin. On top, you have a big graph that shows how the limiter is affecting the sound output. The intensity of the sound in output is represented on the graph in time. The white line represents the effective gain that the limiter is applying time by time, and this is different from the general gain you apply through the gain knob at the bottom and represented through a violet line. If the general gain increases, the violet line increases, and so the white line follows. There is also a green line that represents the ceiling level, indicated through the seal knob at the bottom. This is the maximum volume you want to give to the output sound. Observe what happens. As long as the output sound has peaks under the ceiling, the limiter doesn't do anything and leaves the sound as it is. But when peaks overcome the green line, the limiter limits the effective gain in order to keep such peaks under the ceiling level. The total attenuation applied is represented by the dropped white line you see near the peaks. In this case, the output peaks are represented in two colors: a violet one, which is the peak without any limitation, with the violet gain applied in full, and a white one, that is the sound in output affected by the limiter settings. So to reduce any saturation, you can set the gain you like and reduce the ceiling level as much as you need. At the bottom, you have other important knobs. For example, you can use the saturation knob to find the ceiling effect on the peaks. The attack knob is used to set the time used to reduce the white line level that limits the high peaks. The release knob defines the time taken by the white gain line to come back to its original level. Always check the overall white curve and its transitions. You also have the ahead knob that sets the extra time length of the limiter attenuation after the high peaks. The compression works the same. Usually you prefer a compressor when you need to slightly reduce strong peaks. For this, you can use a plugin called Fruity Compressor. As you can see, you still have the attack and the release knobs. Use gain to increase or decrease the overall output volume, and set the ceiling, here called the threshold, to fix the maximum volume in output. All sound that overcomes this level will be reduced according to the ratio set. One means that the peak is not touched, and a high ratio reduces more the peak volume. There are other plugins you can use, much more advanced. The plugins just seen do limit or compress acting on any sound band in the same way. Other plugins, like Maximus or the Fruity Multiband Compressor, can limit or compress in different ways according to the sound band. Let's see Maximus for example. Maximus has in total 4 sections, low, mid, high and master. Low, in red, acts on the lowest frequencies. Mid, in orange, on the mid ones. High, in yellow, on the highest frequencies. And master, in green, on any band of the signal. Each of these parts is completely independent. First of all, on the extreme left, you have an out-in graph. This sets, for a determined volume for the in or original sound, the respective volume to give to the out sound, the sound in output affected by Maximus. More on the right, a bigger graph shows you how Maximus is acting on the signal. Below the graph, you can set what to see. The green waveforms are the output signals, the violet ones the input signal that is coming to Maximus. Then you have three main lines. The overall gain, which is the white one, that represents the gain the Maximus applies to the sound, the pre-gain in violet, that is the gain applied to the input sound before being processed by Maximus, and the post-gain in light blue color, which is the gain applied after the limitations introduced by Maximus. You can set both pre and post gains through the knobs at the bottom. The ceiling is a very thin line in the middle of the graph. If the input waveform overcomes it, it will be limited. You can set the ceiling through the seal knob and use the trash knob to find the output sound to avoid flat waveforms that can cause square waves and distortion in output. You also have the attack, the release and the ahead knobs, just as seen for the limiter plugin. Each section has its own gain, ceilings and attack release levels. You can apply these settings independently on each frequency band that composes the signal. To define frequency bands, you can use the frequency knobs on the extreme right. Thanks for watching this video. Check out our full guide to learn more for FL Studio 12.